Good morning, students, and welcome to another online physical science class. Today, I am going to start your first chapter, that is measurement. Measurement is a very easy chapter. So, let's start. So, first, start with physical quantity. A physical quantity is a property of a material or system that can be quantified by measurement. A physical quantity can be expressed as the combination of a numerical value and a unit. For example, the physical quantity mass can be quantified as n kg. N is variable, where n is the numerical value and kg is the unit. Suppose 3 kg. Like this, 3 is the numerical value and kg is the unit. In physics, there are 7 fundamental physical quantities that are measured in base or physical fundamental units. They are length, mass, time, electric current, temperature, amount of substance, and luminous intensity. See the diagram, physical quantity and measurement. For this, I have given one diagram so that easily you can understand. And there is a list, a table form, tabular form I have given. Length, unit is meter, symbol M. Quality, unit is kilogram, symbol kg. Time, unit is symbol, unit is second, symbol S. Electricity, unit is ampere, symbol is A. Like this, temperature, Kelvin K, light intensity, candela, CD, mole, MOL, mole, but just a first letter will be different, that will mean small. Symbol is also mole. So, like this, so anything that can be measured is a physical quantity, you can say. For example, to have an idea about a solid body, we require measurements of its length, breadth, volume, mass, density, etc. And thus, length, breadth, volume, mass, density of the solid body which can be measured are the physical quantities. Now, in measuring any physical quantity, some convenient and definite quantity of it is taken as the standard. And in terms of this standard, the physical quantity is measured. This standard is called a unit. For example, let the market be 500 meters from our home and it takes 5 minutes to reach there. From this statement, we can have a definite idea about the distance and the time. Here, a definite length has been taken as standard, which is called 1 meter. This distance of the market from our home is 500 times this standard length. And thus, it is expressed as 500 meter. Similarly, a definite time interval is taken as 1 minute and 5 times. This standard time interval is 5 minutes. To measure a physical quantity, at first, some convenient unit is chosen. And the physical quantity is expressed by a numerical number, which denotes how many times the unit is contained in it. Thus, the measure of a physical quantity is expressed as a number and a unit. Now, different systems of unit. The set of systems of unit is MUPL, is SI, International System of Units. Meter, kilogram, second, ampere, Kelvin, mole, candela, FPS. Another one is FPS, foot, pound, second. MKS or SI you can say, here also meter, kilogram, second. CGS unit, centimeter, gram, second. EMU, electromagnetic unit, centimeter, gram, second, ampere. Ab ampere, okay. ESU, electrostatic unit, centimeter, gram, second, ab coulomb. Now see, I have given in tabular form also. Here length, unit is meter, in SI, in CGS it is centimeter, and in FPS, that is BE system, it is foot, FE. Now mass, SI unit kilogram or kg, CGS unit gram, and FPS unit slug, SL. Next, time, all are second, all units are second. So different systems of unit are used in different parts of the world. These systems are mainly the methods of defining the three fundamental units. The most widely used system of units in CGS are French or metric system. In 1960, at 11th General Conference on Weights and Measures held at Paris, an international system of units is adopted to have a consistent system of units and also to simplify the communications among the scientists. This system of unit is known as Le Système International des Units, abbreviated as SI units. So CGS or French or metric system. First, this system was originated in France, but now it is used in the scientific measurements and also is widely used throughout the world, including India. In this system, the unit of length is centimeter, the unit of mass is gram, and the unit of time is second. From the initial letters of the words centimeter, gram, and second, this system is called the CGS system. Next, SI units. In these systems, in addition to units of length, mass, and time, units of electric current, temperature, luminous intensity, and quantity of substance, that is, 7 basic units in all, are adopted. These are, already I have said in the previous slide, length, mass, time, electric current, temperature, luminous intensity, and quantity of a substance. Units of these are meter, kilogram, second, ampere, kelvin, candela, mole respectively. And symbols are M, kg, S, A, K, cd, and mole respectively. Besides these 7 units, 2 supplementary units are also included in this list. These are radian, RAD in short, and steradian, SR in short, for plane angles and solid angles respectively. In SI and also in CGS, different prefixes are used to express multiples and submultiples of a unit. These are, I am discussing this. First, following points may be noted while writing SI units. Very important points I will discuss. Full stops, comma, etc. are not written after the symbol of the units. For example, we should write CM and not CM dot. Number 2, the symbols of the units are always used in singular form. That is, we write 1M, 5M, etc. and not 5MS. Next, name of a unit is never written in initial capital letter, even if it is named after some person. For example, we write ampere, joule, newton, etc. and not as this A, J and N will not be capital. Next, if a unit is named after a person, the symbol is written in capital letter, but the symbols of other units are not written in capital letters. For example, we write newton, capital N, joule, capital J, meter, small m, kilogram, kg, etc. Next one, when temperature is expressed in Kelvin scale, degree sign is not used, that is, we write 300 K and not 300 degree K. And the last but not the least, units like meter per second, etc. are written as m per s or m s to the power minus 1. A table has been given in your book Please read that table. Their prefixes are there, like giga. Symbol will be G. Multiplicative factor will be 10 to the power 9. Like this mega, symbol will be M. Multiplicative factor will be 10 to the power 6. Like this kilo, symbol is K. Multiplicative factor will be 10 cube. Hecto, H, 10 square. Deca, DA, 10. Deci, small d, 10 to the power minus 1. Centi, C, 10 to the power minus 2. Milli, M, 10 to the power minus 3. Micro, mu, 10 to the power minus 6. Nano, N, 10 to the power minus 9. Pico, P, 10 to the power minus 12. Femto, F, 10 to the power minus 15, etc. Physical quantities having no units. All physical quantities do not have units. These quantities are measured as the ratios of two similar types of quantities. For example, specific heat is the ratio of two quantities of heat. Specific gravity is the ratio of two masses. Atomic weight is the ratio of two weights, etc. Physical quantities having no units cannot possess dimensions. Trigonometric ratios, logarithmic functions, exponential functions, coefficient of friction, strain, Poisson's ratio, specific gravity, refractive index, relative permeability. The units which are independent of each other are known as fundamental units. Derived units are derived from fundamental units. For example, meter is a fundamental unit of length and second is a fundamental unit of time. So you can say that derived units are combination of fundamental units. For example, speed, distance by time, unit meter per second. Acceleration, velocity by time, units meter per second square. Force, mass into acceleration, units kgm per second square. That is Newton, capital N. Energy, force into distance, kgm square per second square. That is Nm, equal to J, joule. Capital N, small m. That is equal to capital J, joule. Change, Q, current into time, units As, that is C, coulomb. Like this. So in science, we have to measure a large number of quantities. So for measuring them, we would require a large number of different types of units. But it is found that although there are infinite number of quantities, units of most of the quantities could be ultimately derived from the units of only three quantities. These three quantities are length, mass, and time. Thus, the units of length, mass, and time, which are independent of each other and from which other units can be derived, are called the fundamental units. The units of other physical quantities which are derived with the help of one or more than one fundamental units are called derived units. For example, let the length and the breadth of a room be 5 meters and 3 meters respectively. Here, meter is a unit of length, so it is a fundamental unit. But the area of the room is 5 meters into 3 meters, that is 15 square meter. Here the unit square meter is obtained by multiplying a fundamental unit of length, meter, by meter. And hence square meter is a derived unit. Modern ideas of standard length and time. The different fundamental units are defined by International Standard Bureau of weights and measures, and prototype standards of measurement of basic units are maintained by different national standard bureau of different countries. In India, standard basic units of measurements are maintained by National Physical Laboratory at New Delhi. Mass 1 kilogram in SI is defined as the mass of International Prototype in the International Bureau of Weights and Measures at Service near Paris, France. Prototype masses are supplied to different national bureau. In CDS system, the unit of mass is gram, which is 1/1000 part of a kilogram. So similarly, we can define the other units also by this process. Now, different types of units, that is necessity of differently sized units for measuring the same physical quantity. First of all, astronomical unit, that is AU. It is the mean distance between the sun and the earth. So 1 AU is equal to 1.496 into 10 to the power minus 11 meter. That is equal to approximate 1.5 into 10 to the power 11 meter. It is used in measuring astronomical distances. So an astronomical unit AU is the average distance between earth and the sun, which is about 93 million miles or 150 million kilometers. Astronomical units are usually used to measure distances within our solar system. Next, light year. It is the distance traveled by light in vacuum in 1 year. That is, 1 light year is equal to 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. That is, into 365 into 24 into 60 into 60 second into equal to 9.46 into 10 to the power 15 meter. You have to remember this. As defined by the International Astronomical Union, IAU, a light year is the distance that light travels in vacuum in 1 Julian year, 365.25 days. Because it includes the word year, the term light year may be misinterpreted as a unit of time. Next, parsec. That is, it is the distance at which an arc of length of 1 AU subtends an angle of 1 second of an arc. 1 parsec is equal to 3.08 into 10 to the power 16 meter equal to 3.26 light year. So 1 parsec is the distance to an object whose parallax angle is 1 arc second. The radius of the arc's orbit equals 1 astronomical unit, that is AU. So an object that is 1 parsec distant is 206.265 AU or 3.26 light years away. And the last one is unified atomic mass unit, that is U. It is equal to the 1/12 of the mass of an atom of carbon 12 isotope. Previously it was known as atomic mass unit, that is AMU. So 1 U is equal to 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg. And 1 kg is equal to 6.022 into 10 to the power 26 U. The Dalton or Unified Atomic Mass Unit, symbols DA or U, is a unit of mass widely used in physics and chemistry. It is defined as 1/12 of the mass of an unbound neutral atom of carbon 12 in its nuclear and electronic ground state and at rest. Dimensions. Dimensional formula is an expression for the unit of a physical quantity in terms of the fundamental quantities. The fundamental quantities are mass, length, and time. A dimensional formula is expressed in terms of powers of m, l, and t. In a diagrammatic form, fundamental units, that means dimensions, has been shown over here. In a tabular form, it has been shown that physical quantity, suppose it is area, unit will be meter square. So dimensional form, it will be L into L, that means length into length square. Next one is velocity, that is unit meter per second or meter second inverse. Dimension L by T, that is length by time. Next, or L into T inverse. third one, acceleration, that is meter per second square, or meter into s to the power minus 2. Dimension L t to the power minus 1 divided by t, that is coming equal to L into t to the power minus 2. Next one, force N, that is Newton, is equal to kg meter per second square. Dimension ML t to the power minus 2. And the last one works, Joule J, kg meter square per second square, that is ML square t to the power minus 2. Dimensions of a physical quantity give the relation of its unit with the units from which it is derived. It is seen that any physical quantity is obtained by using one or more of the three physical quantities, namely length, mass and time. So area, volume, I have already discussed. Volume, length into length into length, that means L cube. Density, mass by volume, that is M by L cube. Speed, distance by time, that is L by t. The powers to which the fundamental units of mass, length and time are raised to represent a derived unit are called dimensions of that unit. As in area and volume, powers of L are raised respectively 2 and 3. So these are called 2-dimensional and 3-dimensional respectively. Thus, the dimensions of a physical quantity are expressed as the powers to which the fundamental units of mass, length and time are raised to obtain the derived unit of the quantity. The fundamental units from which physical quantity is derived are each expressed as capital letters M, L, T, etc. The dimensions are always written within square brackets. It should be noted that ML and T are fundamental quantities sufficient only for these of machines or mechanics and general properties of matter. By denoting the units of other fundamental quantities by proper symbols, namely electric current by I, temperature by K, luminous intensity by CD and amount of substance by mole, the dimensional formulae for all other physical quantities may be obtained. Next, dimensional formula and equation. The dimensional formula of a physical quantity is an expression which gives the fundamental units on which the physical quantity depends and the nature of the dependence. Thus, the dimensional formula of velocity is m0 l1 t to the power minus 1. Is called so you can say when a physical quantity is equated to its dimensional formula, we get the dimensional equation of the physical quantity. Angle is a dimensionless quantity which has an unit. Its unit is radian, that is RAD. Now the last one is ordinary scale. Now you can ask me from where this ordinary scale suddenly has came. Actually, physics is a science based on measurements. We require different suitable measuring devices for measuring different physical quantities. So first we are discussing ordinary scale or linear scale. Along with identifying and describing the magnitude, the ordinal scale shows the relative rank of variables. The properties of the interval are not known. Measurement of non-numeric attributes such as frequency, satisfaction, happiness, etc. An ordinal scale is a scale of measurement that uses levels to classify cases, that is measurements, into ordered classes. Note that an ordinal scale implies that the classes must be put into an order such that each case in one class is considered greater than or less than every case in another class. So we often use ordinary scale for measuring length. It is usually a thin rectangular bar or box, wood, metal or plastic. everyone you have a scale or ruler, we are talking about that only. The length, see the diagram, you will understand. The length of the scale varies from 15 centimeter to 1 meter. If a scale be graduated only in centimeter and millimeter, then the scale is known as meter scale. A meter scale can measure a minimum length currently up to 0.1 centimeter or 0.001 meter and measure maximum length of 1 meter. Use of a scale. Let length of a straight line XY is to be measured. The scale is placed on the straight line in such a way that the straight line is along the length of the scale and the graduations of the scales are perpendicular to the straight line. If the scale be placed in this way, the whatever direction we look, the reading of the ends of the straight line would be the same. Keeping the scale in this way, the readings of the scale in contact with the ends X and Y of the straight line are to be noted. If any end of straight line does not coincide exactly with any particular mark of the scale but lies somewhere in between two marks of the scale, then reading space between the two, then reading is to be taken by eye estimation by mentally dividing the space between the two marks in 10 equal parts. The difference of the readings of the two ends gives the length of the straight line XY. So you have to see the measurement or watch the measurement, keeping your eyes perpendicularly to the scale. Otherwise, parallax error will be maybe. Will face the parallax error. Thank you, students. For any doubts or queries, please email me at sudeshnavan.sma@outlook.com.